Lemoyne Crematory, Night Vision, Stephen and Mark, Three Souls Paranormal. Lemoyne Crematory. Right.
Okay, that's probably never gonna, leave this place, really.
I think like 15 or 16 the most at one time.
Even if we need to go warm in your Jeep?
Yeah.
Like we used to do stuff before then.
Right.
Did you ever find my SD card?
How do you know if that's right? That's brand, isn't it?
It's alright, I got one in here. I was so mad when I was at the Thompson house. I was like, I was like, where the hell is my SD card? Right.
Battery, power bank too, so it's ready. And I'm amazed how long that lasts. Remember I said at Hinsdale House that, illuminator?
Yeah. I think we should just sit down and just.
Yeah. Obviously, I'm sure by the door. That phone would get a bunch of spirit box.
No, the spirit box wasn't active. That's weird, because S-box usually.
Right.
Does good for us.
I would have lost for that man, that grunt.
Right.
That was so loud.
Well, this is us now, Stephen and Mark, we're in the dark with you. No lights, no nothing. You can come out and talk to us and make yourself be known to us now. We already showed you how to use all those devices earlier, and you use them yourself. So you can make them go off anytime you want. Feel free to do so.
Can you light up one of the cat toys, one of the balls?
You don't have to be afraid of us or anything in this room or in this building. Feel free to use it as much as you want. We are not here to harm you or judge you. We just want to know that you're still here with us. That's all we want to know. Seen something. Did that just capture you in that room? Were you walking around back there in the dark? You know, since we turned the lights off and everything, dude, yep. The vibe's changing here.
Yeah, I agree.
It's weird. Now it's weird. There's a lot of car traffic, so that could be messing with, you know, a lot of things could be debunked from car traffic. But a lot of things can be debunked because we actually heard somebody
that drop. Just spiked again.
Yeah, no.
I saw it in the corner of my eye. It went up at least two lights.
We actually heard a man cough or whatever in there. And that was one of the most craziest experiences I've ever had investigating.
I think all the places we've been.
Yeah, we've been through a lot. We're here just like you are. We're just hanging out. You don't have to be shy.
But you know what? We have that IR on, right?
Yeah.
I'm gonna just six-inch one. This is a regular vision one. So it's getting nothing right now because of the light, black and white. But if I put the other IR one up, it's going to pick up above your illuminator. I'm really impressed with those illuminators.
Yeah. I'm going to replay that voice for you. I'm going to see if you can remember who this is. I want to play the full 53 second clip so you can understand what we are talking about. Here we go. This is me and Emily. That's from inside that room.
Play it again, if you don't mind. Can you keep playing this just so I can trigger? Because I'm telling you, that doesn't work. And who was that?
Do you know who that voice is? It says, I and help. Who is this? We don't know who you are. We've been searching for this name for 2 years now. Can you come forward and tell us who you are? Were you in pain the time of your cremation?
Sorry.
play from the other footage that we have, the same voice.
Sound like there's some. Does it sound like the same voice?
I don't know.
Like a female. To me, it sounds very similar.
Well, that yes, that was the same voice, but it was from that
right.
footage from in there. But this thing is starting to pick up shadow and move back here now.
I honestly like what we're doing, just sitting here.
Yeah, I think we should start doing
sometimes, sometimes like overkilling equipment is...
I think we should start trying to do our investigations like this. Just like being more mellow about it.
Right.
One second.
Then you figure we're getting video right now, anyhow.
Right.
We have three cameras going.
Alright. Here we go.
It just picked up, that red light just went on as soon as that voice came in. On the box over there?
Yeah, I know. Who is this? Can you make that voice for us again? Is this you, the little 3-year-old boy? Okay, you made a whisper when I said that.
You're not afraid of us, are you? I know we're two guys here, but...
Yeah,
we mean you no harm whatsoever. We're just here to visit with you and try to communicate with you. It does sound like a child.
It does sound like a child. It does.
Does it sound like a boy or a girl? To me, it sounds like it's a girl.
I mean, but a boy that young?
Yeah.
You know, that voice?
Right.
Could it be him? Could it be a female? It could be. It could be either or. And
you don't have to be afraid of us. Can you tell me how old you are?
You know what's crazy now? Like, because this is shooting into the burn room,
yeah.
All right? And now it's starting to pick up shadow moving.
Mm-hmm.
And when we was live, I thought I seen a shadow behind that door.
Right.
So now, is it like peeking behind the door? And it's like snapping, but it's not fully going off right now.
Even my first thoughts have been child ever since we came in here and the music box started going on.
There we go.
Is that correct? You don't have to be scared of us. I have children too. I have a daughter who's 10 and a son who's 8. I know we look like two big guys sitting here, but you have nothing to be afraid of.
You don't have to be afraid of us. There we go. Child. I think it's definitely a child in here. I think he or she's lost.
And you light up one of the toys? Sorry.
No, you're fine. I think they're lost in here. Because when we first investigated in here, me and Link Frank,
yeah.
There was like battery-powered candles on that table.
Okay.
And some people said they would see the lights turn on and off in here.
Oh, really?
Yeah. Like we're light in this room, like they would see like through like the cracks or windows, like the lights being turned on and off. So.
Something's telling me to do that.
What?
I know it's cold outside. What if we let everything run and just went out for like 5 minutes to see if our cameras catch anything?
We can't. We'll do that. We definitely do that.
Because we definitely don't want you to be scared of us.
No, don't be scared.
Can you set off one of the toys or the music box or one of the red lights that's down there? There's different colored lights. We don't mean to intrude. How about we leave our toys here and we'll go out for a little bit and let you play with them if you need to. Okay? So a light. I just saw a light on the floor.
I did too.
And it is not from traffic.
No, I seen it too. I think it's just picked up. Yeah, it's picking it up.
From right where the base of my tripod is.
Yeah.
Does that sound good? We have three corners of this building covered with a camera.
Yeah.
There, better.
Alright, we gotta get warm for a little bit?
Yeah.
Alright. We're gonna be back in here in a little bit. Just to.
We're gonna go out and get warm and we'll be back, okay? Wow, that orb was insane. It flew from inside that room out to here.
Yeah, that makes no sense because there's no airflow whatsoever in there. Like, we're not walking in there.
No.
I was fine there.
Hope you came through and helped us out.
It is.
It's colder in here.
It is definitely colder than out there now.
It says it's 40.4 degrees in here.
There's no way. It's freezing in here.
How is it so cold in here?
Right? Hey spirits, are you keeping it cold in this building? Any lost souls? Our name is Three Souls Paranormal.
Wanted to come here.
Dude, I'm not even near it. So this way we go off.
I have a very strong feeling that something went off over there.
Yeah, K2 meters is spiking when you said that.
Yeah.
Yeah. So we're going to guess that some of these devices went off when we was outside. Did you do that for us and show us what you can do with these devices? I don't know, maybe since it's dark, are you going to try another S-Pop session? Since we're dark in here?
We can do that, yeah.
I don't know if you have it on you or not. It is so cold in here.
Wow.
Dude, it's colder in here than it was in the Collins house. We're back to try to talk to you again. Thank you, Jason Leader.
You all right with us being here?
It's like it's an empty picture.
You want us to leave again, if so, tell us.
If you want us to leave this building, we'll leave you alone. Say yes to make your devices go off. Do you want us to leave?
This box can't hurt you. We're playing this so that you can speak. If you want to speak to us, you can speak to the box.
That box is so we can hear your voice. All that noise will let us hear your voice.
And we're gonna reiterate again that you don't have to be afraid of us, if we can be in this building. It's here for you to play. I'm wondering now, since this is going off, if I can stick a ring pop in the doorway. Like,
yeah.
Like move it.
It does seem like you're picking something up. Okay. See, you got up and it's not even. Smart. Is that smart? This is smart.
You're allowed to walk around in your spirits. You're allowed to do stuff for us. And if you need help, we'll help you with anything you need help with.
Yeah. You can also learn the spirit bottom of the line.
Yeah.
guy, come forward, and now they're gone. Come forward and talk to us. You're alive. Because that red dot is picking you up back there, you can come forward. You don't have to be afraid and hide in the shadows from us. You can come out and talk to us.
Can you feel the cold temperature?
Is there anything you want to know from us to make you feel more comfortable? Do you want us to leave?
Somebody said he scared us. And one of the best ones was with you. Who scared you? Did we scare you? Sorry if we did.
We don't want to scare you. We don't. You don't have to be scared of us. Okay, thanks. You can come on out now. You're allowed to do that.
See you guys.
Because that blue light is seeing you back there. So don't be afraid to come to that light. You're allowed to do that. All these noise and all these light that we have in here are for us to communicate with you. And for us to see you. So if you're a little boy or a little girl here, don't be afraid. You can come talk to us whenever you want to. How's that sound? Sounds good. What's that?
Put it down over there. Can you tell us your name very clearly? Can you set off one of these lights in here?
Do you want us to show you how the lights work?
Do you want me to come into the other room?
Do you see that blue light that just turned on? Do you see the red light? What's that?
I just thought of that. I wonder if we should try that.
What's that?
You know, there's that Estes method.
The what?
the Estes method or Estes method?
Well, put something over your eyes.
No, where they, where somebody runs a spirit box and asks questions, or somebody asks questions while the spirit box is scanning, and somebody has headphones on so they can't hear what's being said, what's being, what they would say. You were asking questions, I couldn't hear what you were saying, but I would just sound shot whatever I was hearing. But that, I hear so much coming through here, I don't think that would work.
Yeah. Yeah, there's a lot of stations you can pick up there, a lot. So like you had, like, how many stations from Waynesburg College being picked up, and Washington County, Washington Jefferson.
You know what's weird? The big station that's here in this town here is WJPA.
Yeah.
And I actually used to live, I lived on the other side over there, off of 70, by 70 and 79, when they merged, where they both shared the highway for a little bit. The big tower's right there.
Right.
I lived about half to three quarter mile away from there. On the one side of the house that was closest to there, I could hear sometimes if I had something plugged in to the one outlet, I could hear the station through the electrical outlet. It was so weird. That didn't even make sense because, like, I remember one time I had something in there and it didn't even have a speaker on it.
Right.
So how was it, like, letting me hear that? It didn't even make any sense.
I'm going to ask you right now here, do you believe what Dr. Francis Lemoyne did was the right thing to do? Yeah, we can. I mean,
I feel like we're not getting much on the spirit box.
No, spirit box on the
way again. 1876 to 1901. Anybody around that time period would have no idea what a radio is.
Right. Yeah, they have no idea. So yeah, the spirit box is absolutely obsolete here. Mark is going to come in and hang out with you for a little bit.
That's me. Yeah, this is creepy here.
Do you want me, Mark, just to sit here and be silent and have you come out towards us instead of us asking you to come out? We'll let you dictate the terms for us, okay? We'll just be silent and we'll see where this goes. Can you make a tapping noise for us? Mark, is that you moving around there?
Yeah.
Okay, I was just asking, a shadow moving across the floor, that's why.
Across the floor? No.
That's on you?
Is it moving down or not?
No. But you're behind this door, how the hell am I seeing the shadow on the floor?
Is that my foot?
It could have been.
Yeah, it's my foot. Why did my chair just go back?
What's that?
Why did my chair just go back?
Go back where?
I'm on a crooked. Okay, like it's this room, it's not a flat floor in here.
Right.
Like, so all four legs of the chair,
yeah,
are never, like, they're never on all four legs here.
Yeah.
My chair is shifted backwards.
Well, that's weird. Did you move the watch chair?
And all I did was move my foot like this. See how I moved my foot like this? I don't think that would have sent me.
Okay, guess what? You're moving your foot?
Yeah.
And that shadow is not moving on the floor. That red dot didn't. See, that red dot didn't go off.
Chair.
Are you picking Mark up? Oh, I'm asking this box if he's going to answer me. That's weird. Are you near Mark in that other room? There's a couple toys in the furnace part of that. Can you touch them and make them glow blue and red? Did we waste our time coming here? I know you touched a lot of stuff for us first thing when we got here. Maybe he was excited because there was new people in there to visit you. But you haven't touched him since. Can you touch him now for us? Are you curious that we're here? Do you want to know why we're here? Yes? Is that what you're telling us? Yes? We have ways to communicate with you in the afterlife while you're dead, and that's why we are here, to communicate with you. if you're still here with us, can you actually physically see me and Mark? What was that? There's people talking inside. Okay. That picked up your foot?
That's where you're going to have a little count here.
One way in, one way out.
It's really cold. I mean, it's cold in here, but it's, wow, I got really.
Yeah, it's cold.
Really weird.
What time is it?
Chiller. It's 8:30.
We're going to leave soon. We're going to leave in like a half hour. It's 8:30 p.m.
I'm trying to think whenever you signed off. Did you say we were coming back?
I did say that, but...
All right, we could do it in the last half hour.
Yeah, we can. I'll just sit here and hold my phone. As still as possible in here. No lights. Because I have a feeling that with the IR, I think we might see something going on.
Right. I mean, most of the personal experiences we've had have just been stuff we've heard or saw. It's really bright when you're standing in front of that. Holy cow. I didn't realize that thing was that bright.
Can you see the blue and red lights that Mark's holding? You can go over and touch them.
I mean, they seem to settle down some.
That's another piece of equipment that you can touch. They're called dowsing rods. It will tell us if you are here or not. Or if you want us to be here or not.
Can you cross the rods to let us know that you're here? The rods can't hurt you. They're lit up only so that we can see them. Please come over the rods to let us know that you're here. But can you point them to the direction where you are? I can walk towards you. Like I said, I'm a firm believer in dowsing rods, but sometimes they just, the spirits are just aren't in tune. Some people use the dowsing rods and they take like every little single movement as paranormal.
Right. Is this building haunted? Is there actively spirits in this building?
Can you point towards the body on the table over there? I know it's not a real body, but it's there to display how things were back then. If you like the red and blue lights, there's also toys over there you can use to light them up red and blue.
Baron De Palm, you're the first person cremated in this building. Are you here with us? Was that your voice that we heard earlier clear the throat or coffin?
We've seen your ashes down in further in the town, the old Lemoyne House.
Jane Pittman, you were the second person cremated here in this building. You were from Ohio. Is this your voice that we captured in this building 2 years ago? Was this you?
Point them towards the crematory, towards where the, what would you call it, the oven, for lack of a better term?
Yeah.
This would be?
The burner? The oven burner?
Can you cross the rods to let me know that you're here? Shows that whatever makes these work actually does kind of work. The electromagnetic energy.
Right. Dr. Francis Lemoyne, this was your building. You built this. You did the first two cremations here. You were the third person cremated in this building. Your ashes are right out front underneath your headstone. Are you still in this building? Please make yourself be known to us, anybody. Or if you wasn't cremated here, and you just died on the land, please make yourself be known to us.
Cross the rods if you're here with us. If you wish to communicate with us through these. I just have these here as a tool in case you want to use them. It's completely up to you. Point the rods towards Stephen.
Okay.
Yo.
Wow. That cannot be me.
Not you.
And it's picking up. Look at this. This is picking up something too.
Can you do that again for us?
Do you like the pink? There we go again. The first thing I thought of was a little girl, maybe. Do you like pink?
I'm looking at him in a rare, just to...
There's these little devices in here. You see these, how they glow? You can touch them, they're all over this building. Thank you. I'm gonna move away from this, just in case it goes me.
That's not me. It's not me.
Thank you, spirits.
She's bad, I think.
Yeah. Thank you, spirits. Thank you, little girl. We're trying to figure out who you are.
Do you like all these toys that we brought here for you?
We could put some of these toys on the floor for you, and you can play with them. We have some on the floor already.
Can you make the music play again?
Thank you. The music doesn't scare you, does it? See, I'm directly in view of my camera now, so they're... Do you know we're about to leave? Is that why you're coming out and talking to us right now? Or do you want us to stay some more?
You want us to stay? Can you make the music go off again? Oh, that was the cat toy. That was not you. The one on the very top was not you. Just like that, yes.
Yes, keep it going. Roll it around. Keep playing with it. Thank you. You never seen nothing like that when you was a little girl or a little boy when you was growing up. We've been trying to tell you all night that these little devices for us to communicate with you. Yeah, I know you like that. Thank you for talking to us. What's your name, little girl? Can you tell us? Do you want us to leave? Make the music box go off. If you want us to stay, keep the music playing.
Those have been on all night. I haven't gone on. Except for that one time.
Mm-hmm. Are you happy that I showed you how to use these toys? Thank you. So you are happy then. Are you feeling more comfortable with us being here?
Yeah.
There you go. Now it's going to get active.
Which toy do you like better? Do you like them both the same? Can you do them both at the same time?
Can you turn the music on now too? I want to hear some pretty music. Can you turn it on for me?
Can you go back and turn the music on?
You just like the lights of the ball, don't you? You never seen anything like that when you was a kid. It's pretty neat what they have now, huh?
If you are in fact the little girl that's here, can you go turn on the music again?
What kind of animals did you have? Can you stop touching that for 1 second? Don't touch it anymore, okay, please?
That should pick that one.
Yep, there we go. Can you turn the music back on for us? We want to hear the music, please. Thank you. Thank you so much.
It looks like it was just enough to verify.
Yeah, they verified that they wanted us to come back. You want us to come back? One more time for us, please, just to double verify that you want us to come back and talk to you. Are you just walking around the building now? If you're just walking around the building, please make the music go off one more time for us. It's still saying 40 degrees in here. That's crazy. It feels way colder than that. Is that all you got for us tonight? Are you gonna Are you gonna call tonight? And we're gonna call tonight too, and we'll be back another time for you to talk to you. Okay, thank you so much. Thank you, thank you, thank you.
Right? I honestly thought I did it, but it's...
I don't want to overstay my welcome, you know what I'm saying?
Right.
Because we have access to this place at any time, pretty much, I think.
Do you want us to bring back somebody else the next time we come?
Can I bring back Emily and Frank? They were with me 2 years ago when we was here. Can they come back with us? Do you know I wanted to be me and Mark to come back here? Did you walk into the burning room? The furnace room? Is that what just picked you up? Are you going to walk back in here now?
That's too close. That's too far away.
Yeah. Okay.
That's too far away. That wasn't me.
No, that wasn't you. I mean, you were on camera, so.
You have to be towards the corner of that table there.
Right,
you go towards the head of the...
Okay, there's a spike. Can we... Yeah, that's on you. Okay. Are you listening to some music before you go to sleep? Is that what you're doing? Is that why you're over here so you can go to sleep? Thank you. Every time we hear a noise that goes off.
Yeah.
Again, thank you for communicating with us.
There's been several times that has gone off as the music box is going up.
Right.
There's something physically right here that is picking up, that the music box is also picking up.
We appreciate what you did for us tonight. You were super nice. I understand you had to feel comfortable with me and Mark to start communicating with us, and we're glad you did.
We can't wait to come back. We can't wait to come back again and visit you again. Thank you for letting us know that we're welcome back here again.
Alright, alright little kids, every spirit in here. Me and Mark, we're gonna pack up our equipment. I know you like the music box now, you had all night to play with it, but now you gotta go to bed. But we are gonna pack up our equipment and we're gonna leave. But we have every right to come back here to see you, and we're gonna come back to see you. If that's okay with you. Okay, thank you.
That's a funny stop point.
Right. Thank you so much, spirits. And we will be back to see you.
That one right in front of that.
That's probably right at the edge.
Yeah.
Of the threshold for it. That'll come on in. And you literally have to be like the end right here is where you have to be over by the shoulders of this body that's here.
Right. Oh. Light, turn your eyes on.
Okay, let me stand away from here and see if.
Ding! I think that
this has been.
What's that?
This has been awesome.
Yeah, that's been a good night.
Oh, yeah, you couldn't ask for more. Yep. Oh, that was you.
Yeah, that was you.
We could not have asked for more in such a short amount of time than this. Yeah.
I'm happy with anger.
I'm shutting down his camera.
Awesome investigation.
Yes.